this episode, we're going to show you the third principle of green chemistry, less hazardous chemical synthesis.
So John, what does that principle mean to you?
Well, Nadine, as you know, there are often many different ways of synthesizing a molecule, and of these chemical groups, some are safer than others. This principle reminds us to always consider the health and environmental impact of the starting materials and reagents we use to synthesize molecules.
So how do we do that?
Well, scientists can use predictive tools and build from past experiences to help assess the risk associated with all chemical processes.
So for example, in the 1970s, mercury from wastewater coming from an industrial plant that produces chlorine leaked into the water supply of Ontario communities. We've come a long way since then in understanding the hazards of mercury, and so now researchers worldwide are aiming to reduce its use. So John, what cool experiment are we going to do today to demonstrate a safer synthesis of chlorine?
Well, we're going to describe the chloralkali reaction used to produce chlorine and discuss how far it has come over the last 100 years. Currently, there are three competing methods for implementing the chloralkali process: the mercury cell, the diaphragm cell, and the membrane cell. The mercury cell creates hazardous mercury waste, whereas the diaphragm cell uses asbestos-based diaphragms. However, the membrane cell uses a cellulose-based membrane and is the least hazardous of all the chemical processes.
All right, let's go! Now we're at the fume hood. We're going to demonstrate the chloralkali process using the membrane cell. This process produces chlorine gas, so guys, don't try this at home.
In the fume hood, we have a standard electrochemical setup with two salt solutions separated by a membrane.
As we turn on the power source, we start to see bubbles coming out at both electrodes. John, how does this work?
In this process, yellow chlorine gas is produced at one electrode, whereas colorless hydrogen gas is produced at the other electrode. The membrane acts to transport ions between the two compartments.
The production of sodium hydroxide raises the pH of the solution, turning the litmus paper blue.
Well, this reaction seems to work really well. So why wasn't this method used in the first place?
Well, the membrane cell process was not developed until 1970, nearly a century after the development of the mercury and diaphragm cell processes. As scientists became more aware of the dangers of mercury emissions, the need for safer alternatives prompted the creation of membrane cell-based factories. And so scientists worked with policymakers to phase out the mercury cell.
For example, the production of chlorine in Europe using the membrane cell process has increased from less than 25% to 58% in the last 15 years.
It's great to see green chemistry technologies making such a big difference. The third principle to create less hazardous syntheses is not a new concept at all. The search for safer and more environmentally friendly processes will continue to be a priority for scientists.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video, comment, and subscribe to see the rest of our series on the principles of green chemistry.
If you want to learn more about the Green Chemistry Initiative, visit us on our website, on Facebook, or on Twitter.